When I first started playing guitar, I always remember begging my parents to buy me a Boss distortion pedal for Christmas. And my dad, in his infinite wisdom, said, "You know what? You've already got a pretty good amp," and I did at the time, with pretty good distortion in it. You don't want a distortion pedal, you want an EQ pedal. And for Christmas that year, I'll never forget, I got this, the Boss EQ20. I remember thinking at the time, like, dude, this is super lame. I just want the orange pedal that makes my guitar sound dirtier. But as I started to use this pedal, it taught me so much about guitar tone. Namely, I could use it before my amp to either use it as a boost or compensate between the output between my guitars, or use it on acoustic guitar if I was doing gigs going to a PA, which years down the track came in handy. Believe me, I've used this a lot. Or you could use it in the effects loop of your amp to like radically change the tone. But you were stuck either using it pre or post gain. So I remember chatting to my buddy Ryan over at Plagueside Studios, great channel which I would recommend checking out. He's got some amazing stuff on how to use graphic EQ pedals. We were kind of saying, it's like, imagine a pedal that's a graphic EQ that you can use before the amp and in the amp's effects loop. And well, needless to say, when Boss released the EQ200, both of us immediately messaged one another like, dude, have you seen this thing? And I'm really, really lucky to have one on loan at the moment. I'm so excited to try this with a high gain amp and see if it will do what I think it can do, that is, as an amazing pre-boost and an amazing tone shaping device in the effects loop of my amp. First, let's take a look at the front panel and the features, and then let's hear it real quick. There is going to be an in-depth demo coming later, but this thing literally arrived an hour ago. I've unboxed it and I've shot this video for you guys. So here's a first look at the Boss EQ200 pedal. Let's take a quick tour of the front panel. As you can see, you've got your graphic EQ sliders and a nice little graphical display which will show you how much you're boosting or cutting particular bands. You've got a channel select switch on the modes which allow that. And in this case, I could set two totally independent EQs if I have that set up and have them swap channels, you know, a cut and a boost function if that's something that you are after. And there is the ability to cycle through the manual mode, which will follow the sliders, as well as four user presets. There's an on and an off switch, but you can set those functions to be pretty much whatever you like by pressing channel and memory together. And let's just zoom in a little bit there so that we can see what's going on. So let's say, for example, I wanted this foot switch not to just turn the unit on and off. I wanted it to select channel A of the EQ. And I could set my memory function to select channel B and use this as not one, but two totally separate EQs. Furthermore, there is the magic structure control down here where you can set your EQ to either run in parallel or in series. I'm going to leave it set in parallel. And you can choose to have the channels linked or unlinked. So if you were running a stereo rig where you wanted the same EQ applied to both sides of your signal, you could link them. Or, like the example I'm just about to show you, you could use this as two independent EQs, one before your gain stage and one in the effects loop. Furthermore, you can select between different EQ frequencies. There are three contained within. There's also the ability to set the control switches and have all your MIDI implementation, which is further down here, which is pretty awesome. So there's one feature that I'm dying to try with this pedal, and that is the pre-post feature that's going on using EQ1 before the amp and EQB in the amp's effects loop. Let's have a listen to how I would use that. I can go through input and output A and place that before the gain stages on my amp for a classic pre-boost style effect. And then I can also use input and output B in the effects loop of my amplifier to kind of fine tune the tone. So a really classic hard rock and metal amp is a Mesa Boogie Mark series amp, and the bass, middle and treble on those amps are pre-gain. So you essentially shape the pre-gain structure using an EQ, but then the graphic EQ on those amps is after the gain. So that really shapes the tone. So essentially pre-EQ is to shape the feel and post-EQ is to shape the tone. In this case, I have set up the pedal so that the on-off switch turns on channel A and that the memory switch turns on channel B on my pedal. I've got kind of like an uninspiring gain sound with my rectifier at the moment. It's a bit tubby, could do with a pre-boost, and there's no post-processing on the mic, so it's a little bit boomy and a little bit fizzy. So I'm on channel B at the moment. What I'm going to do is just to pull out a bit of extreme low end and a bit of extreme high end. I'll use these two faders here. another frequency I like to pull out is in that like 200 to 400 hertz zone. So just pull a bit of 400 out there, and this will just make things sound a little bit clearer. So that is essentially just cleaning everything up a bit of post-processing, really. Let's go over to channel A. Because what I'm going to do with channel A is I am going to heavily boost the mid-range, and I'm still going to pull out some low-end and a bit of extreme high-end to smooth it out. A lot of modern high-gain amplifier design revolves around cutting low-end before gain and boosting it after the gain. So let's go ahead and do that. I will pull out quite a lot of this low-end here and give it a nice little curve like that. But then this 1.6K frequency range is where the party is absolutely at. So you can see I'm kind of building this pre-boost filter here. We'll pull a bit of this stuff out as well. Kind of emulating like a Tube Screamer or Boss Super Overdrive curve. Furthermore, I can then give it a boost using the overall level control. This is absolute Viagra for your guitar tone. Have a listen to this. So it's an absolutely incredible tone shaping tool because you can use it in this four cable method. Just give me a high gain head and this pedal, and there's pretty much every tone under the sun that you can grab with this. This is the feature that I was so excited about when I saw this, and I'm actually quite amazed that a company has come out and built an EQ pedal that can do this. 110% a winner in my opinion. Like I said at the start of the video, I am going to do an in-depth video using this on a few different sources, using it in series, using it in stereo, using it in parallel, but I just really wanted to show the power of how you can use it with a high gain amp to shape your tone. I figure most of the people who watch this channel want to see that anyway. So that is a really quick look at this guy, the Boss EQ200. I can almost immediately say, I reckon this is the best EQ pedal I've ever tried in my life. Just for the functionality and the flexibility, I'm pretty excited to try this over the next week. So if there are specific questions that you have about this pedal, if there's instruments you would like me to try this on, or use cases you would like me to try this on, let me know in the comments and I will get an in-depth demo done sometime over the next couple of weeks. Thank you guys so much for watching, and thank you to Boss for arranging me to have this on loan for a few weeks. You guys are awesome. I will see you next time.